Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? We have a good vibe.
Welcome to the Hamm Planet Podcast. Subscribe and share to support the show.
Great people. Glorious stories.
How are the women in Green Bay, Wisconsin?
How are the women in Green Bay?
Yeah.
Man, I'm going to be real with you, my guy. Be chilling. For real, for real.
I mean, I'm a huge Cowboys fan, brother, but for you, Pip, I'll say go Pack.
Already.
Oh, damn me. It is you.
You know, I'm here so I won't get fined.
Right, shout out Tesla. Yeah.
Bye, Tesla. We're not financial advisors. Bye, Tesla.
So you're down with that kind of thing, yeah? With the gas prices, too.
Ooh, like good point. Valid argument.
Yeah, Timothy.
Timothy.
Him.
My guy, I have a question, brother. And it's a guy. Deep question.
Hamm University.
I love his school.
For sure.
Excellent education there. So if you could go back to 18-year-old Pip and talk to him, what would you let him know?
Alert. Shall we head to my favorite planet in the galaxy? The planet of good vibes. The planet of good vibes.
The planet of good vibes. The planet of good vibes.
It's time!
All right. I love humanity. I think it's great.
It's all good, man. I think the word you're searching for is Space Ranger.
The Hamm Planet Podcast.
Here's the girl.
In approximately 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Top of the morning, folks. Good afternoon and good evening, ladies and gents. Welcome to the Hamm Planet Podcast. I'm your host, Peter Hamm. And if you're new to the show tonight, love to see it. All about three things here, simple as that. Good vibes, great people, and glorious stories, ladies and gents. If those topics interest you, then you're at a great place. Tonight, I'm fired up. He's defined the odds. After playing 1 year football in high school, got a D1 for ULM, the Warhawks. Got out Warhawk Nation.
You already know.
Transferred to OSU. Played for the Pokes. And what'd he do? He defied odds again, going undrafted and then starting for the Green Bay Packers. Love to see it. And I am honored to have him on the show tonight. Let's give it up for Mr. Lenzy Pipkins.
Yeah, I appreciate that intro, my guy.
Yes, sir. Lenzy, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling good, feeling blessed, man. I'm glad to be here. I appreciate the invite, man.
Absolutely, bro.
We've been planning this for a minute, and I'm glad I could finally, you know, get to be here, actually, and we get to come into fruition with everything, and now we're here.
Brother, I love it. We initially started talking about it when Shane was telling me, I was telling him, but I really want to, you know, step up the show. And he said, brother, you need Lenzy on then. Which you love to see. Lenzy, fired up to have you here tonight, brother. So to get us going, brother, could you walk us through the Lenzy Pipkins?
Oh yeah, most definitely, man. Really started sixth grade. Brother, actually, he was the baller. He was the first one balling in the family. And you know, he was the real deal out there. He showed me everything that I know to this day. And you know, D, he was that dude, and you know, I wanted to be like him. So fifth grade, I wanted to do football. So did Pee Wee for
who was
fifth and sixth grade. Tyler Hendricks, dad Terry Hendricks. He was my coach. Yeah, so I played on the Mansfield Cheetahs. Yeah, I was pretty straight back in the day. You know, I played receiver, corner, You know, I scored some touchdowns, you know, ran some kick returns back, punt returns back. So
yep.
I did everything like that. You know, 81 was my number back then. You know, I loved
good number.
I loved T.O. And then when I got older, it was 21. I loved Dion. I loved Prime. Everybody called me Primetime Pip. You know, so 21, that was a number. And
21, I mean, 21 will always go hard.
Oh yeah, legendary. You know, cornerback, you know, you gotta have that swag, you know.
Yep.
You know, Prime represented all that. And
love, shout out Prime.
Yeah, shout out to Prime for real. Jackson State Prime. Doing their thing.
Yeah, they yeah, are definitely. Bro, they're nasty.
Oh yeah, yeah, he's putting the HBCUs on, man. I love the way the game's going right now.
I am too, bro.
Yeah,
I am too.
Most definitely. Yeah, so you know, did that, 56th grade, you know, ball or whatever. Then, you know, I thought I was a hooper. So, you know, I was scared to play football, you know, when I got to high school or whatever. And, you know, I was just hooping. That's all I really did. Did that, ran track. You know, I was always fast growing up. So, yep. You know, you wanted me on the track team. Football coaches told me to run track. And I didn't even play football. They told me to come run track. So, you know, I used my speed, and I did that. I was fast, you know. I always placing or whatever. And, you know, then junior year in high school, I just got tired of basketball, you know. I played it for so long, and,
it's a different style of grind, I'd say.
Yeah, it is. It is. And, you know.
Hate running the suicide runs.
Yeah, whew, yeah.
It's don't miss those.
Yeah, it's a different type of cardio for sure.
It is way different. I like grass.
Yeah, so, you know, me and the coach, we didn't see eye to eye one time. And,
yep.
You know, just
this happens.
Put it to the side, and, you know, I quit the team or whatever. And I went to the basketball. I went to the football. I went to the football field house, talked to Coach Hamm. And, you know, he thought I was joking. And he was like, man, you playing? Are you serious? He's like, you about to play football? Like, you ain't scared? I was like, no, sir. He's like, man, this is a joke. Like, let me, I'm about to call a basketball coach and see.
Was this on the same day?
Yeah. Same day.
No way.
Yeah, later on in the afternoon. So
you said the basketball, all right, I'm out. And yeah. Then you walk straight to football.
Turn my bag
That's
in.
That's how it happened?
No. It didn't happen like that. This is what happened. I turned my bag in. Had to talk to him, told him I quit or whatever.
Yeah.
And I went to my car or whatever in the parking lot. Man, I started crying. I was mad, like, man, what am I gonna do? Like, man, call my mom or whatever.
Yeah.
Started praying or whatever. And then I was like, man, I wanna play football. Cause I always told my parents, my mom, my family, like, I'm gonna play football again my senior year. Everybody thought I was lying. Nobody really believed me. So then, now this is my junior year right here, so I had one more year of high school.
Yep.
And you know, right then and right there, I quit the basketball team, and I told my mama, hey, I'm about to go start playing football. And my mom said, man, go do it, go talk to him, whatever. And after school was out, I went down to the field house, talked to Coach Hamm, and he went to go talk to the basketball coach or whatever, and they Damn. Talked, and he said, come the next day, come tomorrow, we're going to start workouts. But he's like, man, I'm going to tell you right now. He said, man, this ain't basketball, so we do contact.
Yeah.
He's like, we work hard down here. He's like, man, I had your brother. He was a great athlete. He's a great player for me. He's like, I expect the same out of you. He's like, bud, we're gonna teach you the game. He said, nothing's gonna be handed to you, nothing's gonna be given to you. So you gotta get it. So you gotta earn it. He said, we already have our guys, so we're loyal here. He's like, so he's like, if you come here and do your thing, so you'll play for me.
Right.
So, you know, he wasn't even talking about going to play college or league or anything like that.
That wasn't even
in my head. Right. I just right then and right there, I'm gonna play football right now. And, man, it was a Nike football training camp combine, like, 3 weeks later. That's how crazy, that's how life works.
You know,
everything happened for a reason.
I remember those, bro. Those were lit.
Spark,
those were
Spark
huge.
Combine. So, yeah,
Spark.
They came to Dallas, Spark. Whatever, you know, top athletes in the area or whatever. Everybody who wanted to go to that camp, you know, they could
Everyone.
Go.
Everyone. It was like
it was big. It was big. You know, it was the tour went around the whole country or whatever. And you know, Dallas, we always have top athletes. And went there. Never, you know, never played high school football at all. I went there, and I stole the show, man. I ran a 4.4. I had the fastest 40 there. Had the one of the top fastest 40s in the country that year. You know, I started getting recruited immediately. Arizona State, Texas A&M, all these big schools, man. They just started recruiting me out of nowhere. And I'm on the radar. And the next day was the opening, and I was at TCU. And this is the top 50 football players in the Dallas area were invited to this invite only. And I got invited just because I had a big day at the camp, and I had all these reporters talking to me, all these coaches.
Damn.
All these recruiters talk to me. They're like, man, like, why haven't you been playing? Like, where have you been? Like, man, I thought I was a hooper. Like, man, you about to get on the scene. You know what I'm saying? You about to blow up. Like, this is crazy. Like, you 6 foot. You know, running four four. Like, this is crazy.
Was
like,
this before you had started full time with the football team?
Yeah,
you played a game.
Yeah, this
right?
is before even spring ball had started. Like, I literally had quit the basketball team three weeks before I went to the Nike football combine, and you know, I stole the show, and that's when I started getting on the recruiting trail. Started going to all these camps, these unofficial visits and stuff, and all these coaches and stuff. They were telling me like, "Hey, we aren't gonna offer you until we see you play a few games. We want to see what you really are like." Like you look like Tarzan, but we want to see if you don't play like Jane. You know, basically they saying I passed the eye test, but they want to see if I'm gonna go out there and be physical like what a corner is supposed to be with my size. You know, so you know I had to go out there and get it. And you know, I was grinding every day. I always had a strong work ethic, and you know, I sacrificed everything to go and get it. And you know, Arizona State is crazy. They gave me an offer, bro, and new staff. I went to a visit down there that summer, and it was crazy.
This is Sun Devils, right?
Yeah, the Sun Devils. Yeah. Went to Tempe that summer. My parents. We drove down there about 16, 17 hours. It was dope. We did my visit. It was crazy.
I mean, I would love
did to the tour. Man, it was dope. Man, it was beautiful. One of the most beautiful places still to this day. I love Arizona to this day still. And you know, I thought I was gonna be a Sun Devil, you know, and then that year, you know, they had a super squad. They had Osweiler, you know, Vontaze Burfict, Omar Bolden, they had a squad, you know. And after that, Coach Erickson and the staff, they got fired like within the first few games of the season, the new staff, you know. They was like, man, who is this guy? He hasn't been playing football. And, you know, took my scholarship away, so I had zero offers by the end of the year. And I was waiting, man, and Monroe came around. I started sending my film to every school in the country, bro. Like I made my own huddle, made my own highlight tape. I did everything myself, bro. Like I was grinding. I really wanted to go D1, so I didn't have any offers then. And I went to go do all that, and nobody was hitting me back really. And Monroe, I sent my film to Monroe, whatever, and they got it, and they hit me up and they gave me an offer the next day or whatever. And this is my mom's birthday. They gave me an offer. And
love that.
Yeah.
Good, great birthday present.
Man, crazy. December 9th, 2011. It's crazy. I'll never forget that day. They gave me an offer, whatever. Then boom, 2 hours later that same day, University of New Mexico gave me an offer. So the same night I had two offers. So I'm like, man, this is crazy. Like my heart, everything. Bro,
thank
dropped.
God. Everything
like,
changed.
Yeah, facts. Yeah. Like I was like, man, I'll call my mom, my dad, my brother. It was crazy. Man, I just got an offer, man. It's crazy, this and that. So then man, went to my business, whatever. Ended up choosing Monroe, and that was all she wrote. Man, went to Monroe, played there, started there for 3 years, and then transferred to Oklahoma State, and so did my thing there, man. And you know, went undrafted. You know, played in the league for 4 years. You know, got an injury, got hurt, and you know now I'm done playing.
It's a violent
game.
And
now we're here. Yeah, now we're here.
Well. Brother, I know it was a journey that defied the odds.
Definitely.
I mean, that's just so crazy that it was on your mom's birthday, and also the fact that you played 1 year just coming from basketball.
Yeah, it's crazy, bro.
I think about like if I had tried to switch a sport.
Yeah.
my senior year, I probably couldn't pull it off. So that's respect.
Yeah.
That's respect. Brother, okay, so one big part that you've mentioned that played a big role in, like, keeping your drive at all-time highs is your mom, your dad, and your brother. When I was asking you your three heroes,
right,
you said your mom, your dad, your brother, which I love to see it. Family strong.
No, definitely.
And, bro, I just like for you to hear about, like, how do they play a key part in, you know, making what has happened happen.
Man, just that that family, that foundation, man, that's everything. And, you know, my parents and my brother, they have been there since day one, always strongly supported each other and everything that we all do, not just me, you know. We all hold each other down. We're always there for each other. And it's, you know, it's unconditional no matter what. It's going to be tough love,
you know,
soft love, real love, everything. Like, it's everything.
Everything in between.
And you feel it and you know it's there. And, you know, I go hard. You know, I don't want to let them down. They don't want to let me down. They don't want to let each other down, the family. So we all go hard.
Yeah.
You know, and they always, seeing my parents, how they held the family down, they gave us that blue collar structure that made us, showed us, like, hey, you got to work hard, and you work hard, and you get blessed for what you work hard and do. You know, you reap what you sow. You know, you're going to reap the fruits of your labor. So that grind is real. That work ethic is strong. The self-dedication, you know, self-sacrifice,
yeah,
all that is real. My parents, they implemented that. My brother, they showed that. And that's why we've all been, you know, successful. And God has continued to bless each and every one of us. That's it right there. That's the recipe right there.
Yeah.
That's the sauce.
That's the sauce, ladies and gents. So you have just your one brother, right, Pip?
Oh, yeah, D. That's it.
Yeah.
It's me and D.
How much older is D?
He's 2 years older than me. He's 30.
Respect.
Oh, yeah.
I got a big brother, too. So we got the same big bro dynamic.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Pip, brother, what did your parents do, like, growing up? Were they with you a lot, or were they grinding all the time? Was your mom with you at home?
Oh, yeah. You know, yeah. Both my parents, yeah, they was there for sure. It was grinding. Yeah, both grinding. You know, Pops was a firefighter, you know, working his way up, you know, the chain. Working his way up the ladder,
bro,
you know.
Salute to our firefighters.
You know, yeah, salute to all the firefighters.
You know, Love our firefighters.
All the civil service workers out there. Salute to everybody. Sacrifice out there. Love.
Yeah.
You know, mom, home health. You know, she's in the home health industry, and you know, doing good in that.
That's the industry we need.
So yeah. So you know, both my parents are in the industry of, you know, service of helping people and helping others. So that's what's always been good for me, because I've always wanted to help people out and wanted to help people try to achieve and reach their goals too. So my parents have shown me that through the occupation and their careers, through their life, their profession.
Brother, it's a beautiful thing. I'm lucky to say I've had that too. And, you know, now that we're getting kind of older, we're still young.
Yeah.
We're still young and spry, but, you know, as we start to become parents, I feel like, or maybe not just parents, just as we get older, we start to notice, like, everything that we do has an effect on, you know, the people around us or the people who rely on us, look up to us. And they're everywhere. And they are. Brother, scooting and booting right along. Brother, who is your favorite? I know this is a tough one, but who's your favorite coach you've had? And why were they such a great mentor and coach to you? If you can't narrow it down to one.
My favorite coach? Coach Duffy, my coach from Oklahoma State, man. You know, he's always been a genuine, down-to-earth, real, solid. You know, always had real grown man conversation, always treated me like a grown man, not like a little boy. So I've always respected him, and he's always, you know, like I said, you've always been blunt and told me what it is and what I had to do in order to get somewhere, football, in order, you know, that could be life-changing, that I could change my life and help out the people around me. And, you know, I listened to him. Yeah, he gave me the blueprint. He gave me the blueprint. Yeah. And, you know, and he showed me by the players that he was able to coach from the years previous before I got to Oklahoma State that were grad transfers. Hey, if you come here and you do this and you handle your business, you can play in the league. We can get you to the league.
Yeah.
You know, and I saw that, and I talked to those guys before me, and I was able to follow those same footsteps, and I was glad I was able to do that and let that coach lead me. And he's still to this day, we talk, try to talk him there once a month, and we're just really close, you know. And I love that man, you know, love his kids, you know, his wife, his family, you know, good man. He's close to my parents and my family as well too, and you know, it's a relationship I'm gonna have for life, you know, and
I love it.
Nothing but the, they wish him nothing but the best. He's leading those young men to the right way up there.
Is he still at OK State?
Yeah, he's still there. Yeah, he's been there.
Is he a lifer? Long time. You think?
He said what now?
A lifer, like gonna until he retires?
He'll be there for a long time. He'll be there. Yeah, all he has to do is just keep on producing and keep on making those young boys ball, because they balling every year, you know. OSU always top 25 and defense always top 10, so as long as they keep balling and as deep the DBs keep doing their thing, hey he's there.
And one thing I love is that how you said he gave you the blueprint.
Yeah,
it takes a lot of sacrifice for coaches to not only just coach but to go that extra mile to say, okay, I after practice, outside of practice, this is what you need to do to make what you want to happen come to reality.
Right.
And that's, I'd say the main thing that makes a great coach is when they're doing that outside of, off the field.
Right, right.
Being there for you. Feeling like you can just count on them and they're going to just shoot you straight. Brother, scooting and booting along, we've got a lot of things I'd love to dive into, brother, but there's one that I'm just really curious about.
Talk to me.
Brother, Green Bay.
Yes, sir. Go, Green, Pat, go.
Go. I mean, I'm a huge Cowboys fan, brother, but for you, Pip, I'll say go, Pat, go.
Already.
And, brother, Green Bay, Wisconsin. What I'm curious about, brother, is how are the women in Green Bay, Wisconsin?
How are the women in Green Bay?
Yeah.
Man, I'm gonna be real with you, my guy.
I'd love to hear it, brother.
What my flavor? They weren't my type, man. In Green Bay, it wasn't the city, man. It's, yeah, that's why I love Green Bay. Green Bay is one of those cities that make you stay focused. You know, it's not a lot of temptation. It's not a lot of distraction there. And I ain't going to say it's not a lot. There's none at all. There's zero. You know.
Zero. 0% distraction.
If you see something there, then that's somebody's wife or that's somebody's girl.
Or you're seeing shit.
Yeah, that's one of your teammates' girls. So you don't, there's nothing there, you know, Green Bay. Green Bay is one of them towns that you're going to stay focused. You're going to save your money. There's nowhere to shop. And that's why they ball, and that's why they're so good every single year. There's no distractions. All it is football, and it's 100% football, and that's why they always cold.
They're cold. It's cold. I mean, it's a special place. I mean, that's the only sport that Wisconsin has or Green Bay has, right? Like major team.
Milwaukee Bucks about an hour and a half away.
Yep.
Yeah.
Bro, Green Bay. Well, we got a lot we can dive into in Green Bay. But first, we're going to take a quick commercial break.
Now a word from our sponsors.
Howdy there, ladies and gents. It's your good friend, Commercial Break Peter. Here to let you know that today's episode is brought to you by Unify Commerce. Say it with me now. Unify Commerce. Yes, guys, that is spelled UNIFI commerce.com. Guys, Unify is in fact my company, and I thought I'd go ahead and plug them on here so you guys can know a little bit of what I do outside of having a great time on the podcast. Guys, Unify is a social technology company that simply helps other companies take their social presence to the next level. Simple as that. And the primary service I want to highlight is professional video creation. Guys, if your company is in need of an exceptional video that shows what you do, why you do it, how you do it, and why it is so valuable, then Unify is here to help. And Unify can create an exceptional advertisement that can really help build awareness and drive sales for your company. We have been in business since the summer of 2018 and helping businesses grow and capitalize on the opportunities that social presence can offer is something we love to do. So if you need a next level video, you need a next level team on your side, and that is Unify. So guys, go ahead and visit unifycommerce.com if you want to learn more. And if you want to inquire about working with us, simply go to the Work With Us tab and we would love to connect. Anyways, y'all, back to the show. It's welcome back to the good old Hamm Planet podcast. We're happy to see you. We really are, Shane.
We are happy to see you.
Are you? Oh, yeah, he's happy to see you. Pip, happy to see you.
We're here.
We're here, baby. We are here.
What's going on?
My guy, I have a question, bro. And it's a deep question. It's a deep question, but it's something that I definitely think is very valuable to a lot of people. And I would love to hear it, brother. So if you could go back to 18-year-old Pip and talk to him, what would you let him know?
18 years old, me.
Yeah.
And I would tell myself, slow down, live life. You're going to make mistakes. Learn from them. Grow from them. Teach others, help others, and you continue to be blessed. And worry about yourself in the fact of just don't be worried about everybody else. Don't be worried about Joe Blow. Don't be worried about Teresa. Don't be worried about Mario. Don't be worried about, you know, worry about yourself. We all dealing with something. We all going through right. Something. Deal with yourself. Handle yourself, and then the rest will handle itself. You know, control what you can't control, and then that's what I would tell. That's what I tell young Pip. Control what you can't control. Everything else is gonna happen, and you just gotta react. You know, life is gonna throw you lemons. You know, you gotta react. You know,
could throw you a grapefruit. Could throw you a pineapple at your head.
Hey, mango.
Could throw a mango. Could throw a pomegranate. I mean, the list goes on and on. Life will do some shit that you have never even seen or occurred. Yeah. Or
put you in that blender, blend you up, and
smack you in the lips out of nowhere. Yeah. You know, smack you again.
It can take you for a roller coaster, and every time you go through any roller coasters, you gain wisdom, you gain knowledge, you gain strength.
I see it through.
Yeah. You love to see it. So what a perfect segue to another thing I wanted to bring up. Brother Pip, on good old April 18th, 2018, you shared something else that I thought was great, which was the quote, "Rewards last longer than pain." Brother, when it comes to the phrase, the great quote, "Rewards last longer than pain," what does that mean to you, brother?
Rewards last longer than pain.
Yeah.
Man, you're going to be down in life, you know. You're going to reach valleys, you know. You're going to reach peaks, you know. You're going to be on the mountain. You know, it's going to be good things that happen to you. You're going to have bad days. You're going to have good days. But you're going to have more better days than you have bad days. And no matter how long you was down for, as soon as you up, you feel better. You feel good, you know.
Yep.
And you're going to go through, you know what I'm saying, that tunnel. And then once you start seeing the light, you know, the rewards, you know, and it feels good. And it made you humble. It made you thirsty for success to get on the other side. Because, you Absolutely. Know, the other side of fear is success, you know, is reward, you know. So
it is. And that's where reward that's even inconceivable is, you know, when you go beyond that. Like, you know, for some people, they'll never think, oh, I'm going to make $1 million or a few million dollars. But when they start thinking differently, it can occur.
Sorry, technical difficulties. Cameraman is drunk. Back to the show now.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Good Old Hamm Planet Podcast. We're happy to see you. Shane Brandis in the house tonight. Let's give it up.
Real one.
Thanks, boys. Happy to be back. Always good to be back.
Always great to have you, brother. Yeah. The building always feels a little bit more cozy. But in like a architectural way, not like a blanket way. You know what I'm saying?
Sort of, brother.
It's great. It's great to have Brother Shane in the building tonight, ladies and gents. Brother Shane, what is the best golf score you've ever achieved?
Brother, I've actually only shot even par twice.
How many shots is that? 70?
That was two. I shot 71. Like, that was the par on the course was 71. So very hard to achieve. Only done that twice in my life. Been playing golf since, you know, third grade. I mean, not all the time.
Oof.
Not all the time. Obviously not practicing, you know, stuff like that. But
always
I've had a club in my hand from a young age. It's just hard, man. Golf's it's a mental grind as much as it is a physical grind, because you just got to move on to the next shot. You're gonna hit some trash ones, and
yeah,
it's tough, man. That's why we love it so much. That's why Pip's addicted to it.
The bug is real.
He's gonna be shooting the 80s no time, the 70s. Yep.
I'm gonna get there.
You had a smooth stroke. I saw like a chip you did out on the course, right over a sand trap, like a very respectable shot. And I was like, damn, good shit. Like, I definitely would have fucked that up.
Yeah, I appreciate that, bro. Hey, honestly,
yeah, no, I meant that for sure. That was a great shot.
Honestly, bro, what I do, man, I'm really a nerd, man. Like, I want to be good at whatever I do, whatever I start. So I'll research anything, yeah, everything, so I get really good at something. And I still research, but I still want to be the best. So, bro, anytime I have questions or want to look something up at golf, I just go on YouTube and type it in what comes to my mind. So I've been looking up, like, how to chip over bunker, what foot to play it on, what to do this. And, you know, I have sponge memory, so that goes into play when I'm on my golf grind. So I have those mental notes taken all throughout the course, you know.
And it gets you prepared.
Yeah, no, definitely. You know, it's peace. You know, I never thought I would find, you know, a sport or, you know, a hobby that would bring peace and
for sure, bro.
And bring some type of, you know, tranquility to mind, because
so much peace. You
out there, it's just green grass. Yeah, you out there with nature, you know, too. Facts. And you, it's a different mindset.
So healthy.
It is healthy for you. And people don't get it. You know, like, if you would have asked me this 9 months ago, I would have said, man, what, golf? Nah, forget it. That's lame. They ain't athletes. They don't do this. They don't do that. I respect every single one of them cats out there on that tour and who out there who grind, who are amateurs as well.
Are they full-blown legit athletes?
Golf is the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. Yeah.
Or are they brainiacs?
You heard it here first.
The hardest
folks.
Thing I've ever done in my life, bro.
It's hard.
It's hard, bro. It's humbling.
Crazy. It really is.
It's humbling.
They're a mix of brainiac and athlete.
I'm telling you, it's mm-hmm. bro, it's more mental than anything.
Definitely. Oh, it is.
The swing thoughts you have, like when you're hitting a shot, like there's water short, and you're like, don't hit it there, you know, like,
right.
I can't hit it.
Sometimes you're just pissed off and want to hit it in there, throw your club.
It's that's why there's nothing better than just hitting a pure golf shot. Do that. Doing exactly what you want to do.
Hearing that sound.
Yeah, that sound. Like
you're cutting a carrot.
Oh, it's, yeah.
Yeah.
Like you're cutting a carrot.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Pip, you honestly got in early. You think you got in late, but it's just a game you can play. Bro, we can be playing golf forever, bro.
Yeah, no, definitely.
Ever.
That's the great thing about golf is you can be like a 52-year-old rookie.
Still hitting bombs.
But we're starting younger. We're going to be prepared. I mean, we're going to fuck anyone up at our country clubs.
Definitely, for sure. That's
in a positive way, in a golfing competitive way. Athletically challenged way.
Definitely.
See it. Love it. Love to see it. Back to the show.
Brother, that's your lemonade.
I get it. I get it afterwards, you know. We got to promote the water.
We do. Everyone needs some water.
Y'all see this hair? This hair healthy. This is for water.
Yep.
This one drinking water.
Water.
Yeah.
Water. Drink it.
So y'all skin healthy too. I got that healthy skin from water.
Water.
I got some boys from Philly. Them boys like water. Them boys like water. Water.
The boys in Philly ain't saying it right there.
He's saying it right. We from the South.
It's a cup of water.
We from the South. You can ask anybody to say the same word from different regions of the country, and they'll be different. And they'll say different. A different way. New Orleans, some water. They gonna say some water. Oh no, I'm here. You know, I'm here, so I won't get fined.
VIP.
Oh, for real?
This is Fines here only gifts. I feel like.
Right, but I need them all. I love me some gifts.
I love a good
gift. I don't like surprise gifts. I like blunt gifts where you
know what I'm gonna get.
Tell me what it is.
Yes.
Don't play with my head. I don't like that anxiety.
Can't do that
anxiety,
shit anymore.
Anxiety be real. You hear me? My anxiety be real, real high. I don't need won't forget that.
Forget it.
Tell me what it is. We blunt over here. Mm-hmm.
I couldn't agree more. I honestly, surprises, they fuck me up.
Yeah.
They do.
Yeah.
They do every time. Because then I'm thinking, oh, it's going to be this, so I got to do that. And I hate to see it. Let me know what it is. Let's make it happen. And that's always amazing to get a good gift.
Already.
Brother Shane, out of your golf clubs that you own, what was your latest gifted club?
Gifted club, like the most recent club somebody has given me?
I believe that'd be accurate, brother.
That's a gift, huh? Brother, I haven't got gifted any clubs. golf's an expensive game, man. People ain't trying to buy shit.
It is.
You.
It
especially,
is.
You know, my parents definitely are.
You're highly competitive, too. So, I mean, do you have a decent set of what? Weapons?
I do have a decent set of weapons, but I've had them for 7 years now, 8 years. So I have some P790s, which shout out Taylor May. You feel me?
Yes, sir. Taylor May gang. Team, so step
excited
over
to get
here.
Those, but ordered them in September 2021. Here we are, March 2022. Still have not received them.
Whoa.
So I don't know.
Going on?
It's just supply chain. Supply chain is just. You know,
left
up.
Yeah, it's a lot of clubs and stuff stuck in the ocean with those on those ships and stuff. So there's a lot of back orders right now.
Yep.
My other guys, he ordered the Sim 2 iron set and back in November, and he still hasn't received those. So like,
what?
It's real. You know, I'm in the trucking industry. You know, I know about that, and I know that those cargo ships are stuck in the middle of the ocean right now. So, like, it's a lot of stuff on those cargo ships. So, and those are golf clubs included.
Shit.
So, on those ships, I know a lot of them are, you know, for oil. But the ones that are carrying shit, aren't they always carrying just all types, everything?
Everything. The shoes, everything, all types of
It's like every resource is on some of those things.
Definitely. Facts. Definitely.
I mean, that's where, yeah. I mean, Nikes and stuff have to make it over here.
You got to remember the way the transportation works in the world is it comes from either a train, a plane, a bus, a ship, and it's delivered on a motherfucking truck.
Yep.
That's right. Every time the truck is a key piece to close the deal.
So many 18-wheelers out there. They'll never go away.
So many.
Gotta have the shit.
Well, apparently they're going to be autonomous. Is what I'm hearing.
I don't know how I feel about that.
They're going to be powered by natural gas and batteries, and they're going to
drive themselves.
Drive themselves. You buying it? Not buying it? Sell?
I'm not a huge fan of that, bro. I just don't know. I can understand people who have Teslas and stuff.
I want old-fashioned driving to stick around.
Imagine sitting behind the wheel or something, you know? I'm just made it. I don't know. I just couldn't trust it.
Pip, have you ever experienced autonomous driving, brother?
No, I have not. I've seen it on YouTube. That's next, you know, that's next up, you know, these robots and all that type of stuff. That's next.
Honestly, I've done it many times. It's impressive, not gonna lie. But it takes a lot of getting used to.
Probably scared, boy.
Bro, I shit my pants. Pants the first time I did it.
Right,
I was like, oh.
With how sketchy driving is in general, you know, you're always getting cut off, having to slam your brakes and stuff. I'm just not trying to be chilling. And then, I trust an automated system.
I agree. It takes practice, which is a thing with it. Because, I mean, you have to even... you know, see if the feature works. You have to try it, and then you have to continually get used to it and trust it. It's pretty nuts.
That is nuts. Shout out Tesla, though, and Elon.
Yeah. Buy Tesla. We're not financial advisors. Buy Tesla, though.
So you're down with that kind of thing, yeah. With the gas prices, too.
Good point. Valid argument.
Yeah.
Brother Lindsay, do you have a Tesla or want a Tesla one day?
Do not own a Tesla. Teslas are dope. I don't know. You know, I don't know if I'll ever own a Tesla. You know, I don't know. I can't answer that for you right now, my guy.
My guy, I completely understand.
I feel that.
You feel me, bro? I feel that. Brother, then what is your dream vehicle?
I've had my dream vehicles. You know, I've had a Jeep. I always wanted a Jeep. I had a Camaro. I always wanted a Camaro. And I had an Audi. You know, I always wanted an Audi. I got a pickup truck. I always wanted a pickup truck. You know, I'm.
Which is you like good. The most?
Which one have I liked the most?
Yeah, that's a lot.
I love that Jeep. That Jeep was sexy. That thing was sitting high. It was sitting right. You know, it was a head turner. It was a head banger for sure. For real,
they knew. I had a red firefighter,
fire engine truck, red. That's that red. Yeah, it was right for sure.
Did your dad help you do the firefighter red?
No, he didn't help me do it, but you know he inspired me. You know?
That's what I was.
If he wasn't a firefighter, my brother wasn't a firefighter. That red, that was just something about that red. Red, sexy. It's just sparkling. It looked like a candy apple fresh out the syrup. You know, when you pull it out, it's dripping. It's dripping.
Caramel.
Yeah. No. The red one.
Oh, red the pure candy, the good shit.
He big.
Ooh wee! I love eating those things. They fuck my teeth up, but they're great.
This candy, it's all bad for you. You just gotta, you gotta pray and then it'll be good.
Every time you eat a candy, ladies and gents, just pray. You'll be good. Damn, some people will just praying all the time now, which would be good. Why not? You know, that'd be great. All right, brothers. I hear some faint Nicki Minaj in the background. I'm gonna get her turned down. I know she's turning up. I'm turning her down.
Oh, Nikki, right?
Love Nikki.
Yeah, me too. But, love me some Nikki.
And now a word from our sponsors.
It's your man, Peter Hamm, checking on in here. And today, ladies and gents, I'm going to give three simple things that anyone can do that helps the show tremendously.
What?
Number one, ladies and gents. Number one is to simply invite your Facebook friends to like the page. All you got to do is go to Facebook, type in Hamm Planet Podcast. It'll take you to our page. You will then see a section that says invite friends. You click select all. It sends your friends a little notification. It's not too overbearing. And it invites them to like the page. This is tremendously valuable. That's number one. Number two, ladies and gents, is to provide a good old 5-star review on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and or Facebook.
Three.
Thirdly, y'all, is engage. Simply feel free to share anything. Feel free to comment on anything. Say whatever you want. You can engage on our page via Facebook. You can engage on our Instagram. We've got Hamm Planet, and we also have at Hamm Planet Clips. And we're on TikTok. I gave in. All the kids are doing it, so now we're doing it. TikTok at Hamm Planet Clips. And of course, YouTube, Hamm Planet Podcast Clips. So, ladies and gents, that's going to wrap up the video for today. These are three simple actions that you can do that will help the Hamm Planet Podcast tremendously. So, that being said, ladies and gents, I will see your beautiful faces soon. Have a great day. The Would You Rather segment. We're fired up. We have the one and only Mr. Lenzy Pipkins in the house, ladies and gents.
Whoa.
Let's fire up. Pip, first question. Are you ready, good sir?
Let's get it.
Okay. Chicago Bulls. Yep. Starting off with a kind of easy question. Or not that crazy. I mean, it's not that crazy. It's not necessarily easy. Brother Lenzy, would you rather never sing or never dance again?
Damn, that's tough.
It's tough. I mean, I'm sorry, brother. These are some tough options.
I'd rather never dance again.
Yeah, I think I'm on the same page. Well, good singer. Like, people don't like it when they sing. Next question. Lenzy, would you rather eat nothing but salad or eat nothing but dessert for an entire week?
Salad.
Salad every meal.
Yeah.
Same.
I have a breakfast salad, a lunch salad, dinner salad. Mm-hmm. Like muffin salad. Mm.
Muffin salad?
Muffin, potato, eggs.
Wait. Are you talking an actual muffin inside of a lettuce salad? Yeah. Respect, bro. That's a new thing. I mean, I don't feel like people know about that.
You heard from me first.
That's like a delicious crouton.
Right, I'm him. Himothy. Hamm University.
I love his school.
For sure.
Excellent education there. Next, would you rather? Lenzy, would you rather be married to a 10 with a bad personality or be married to a 6 with an amazing personality?
Man. Yep. I'm gonna have a 6.
I feel like you got at least, because the 10 will.
Headache. That's a headache.
Yep.
He'll be divorced within a year.
Divorce, yo, a mess.
Not it, my guy.
My guy, I'm right there with you, brother. I couldn't agree more. amazing personality, has a longevity aspect to it. All right, Pip. Scooting the boot right along. They're getting a little crazy, but they're intriguing. Our next one is, would you rather be able to see 10 minutes into your own future or 10 minutes into the future of anyone except yourself? It's tough. Both good advantages. Kind of all right, scary. 10
minutes into my future.
Yeah. You know what? I agree. I feel like if I saw other people's, that'd mess me up. Because what if you would see someone's 10 minutes in the future and it's not good?
Right.
Like, I don't want that. I definitely don't. That would not be good. You rather be able to slow down time by 10% or jump 3 times higher than you, Lenzy Pipkins, can jump right now? Do you want to be a super jumper, or do you want to be able to say, hold up, slow it down 10% slower? 10% doesn't do shit. I don't know why. I'm picking jumping.
Man, yeah. I'll be a leaper.
Bro, I wouldn't. If I could jump that high, that'd be huge.
Yeah, I'd be a leaper for sure.
Could definitely dunk aggressively if I could jump 3 times. Need at least 2, though, first. Big man, big unit, big
grande.
Next question, ladies and gents.
Large.
Would you rather be the first person to explore a planet or be an inventor of a drug that cures a deadly disease?
I'd rather be an inventor of a drug that kills deadly diseases. Therefore, I'll be responsible, saving lives. And therefore, I'll be known as Captain Save.
Honestly, I'm on the same page. No doubt. That's an easy one to me. If you could save the world, that's way cooler than finding a planet that no one can do shit with.
You hear me? Definitely. Like, I'll let it be a person that would save some really, you know, some strong stuff that the doctors gang seen it put a nail on.
Yep.
You know.
Honestly, shitty second option. Next question. Would you rather be able to speak all languages in the world or be able to speak to all animals in the world?
Eliza Thornberry, Dr. Doolittle.
Dr. Doolittle, Little Schoolil.
I'd rather be able to talk to animals. My dog, me and my dog, we'd be vibing. You know, sometimes I really wouldn't be knowing one another. What's on your mind, little homie? You know, like.
So much, Sam.
That's my boy. Like I love him to death. His name Gucci. You know, I love my dog.
Shout out Gucci.
Shout out to Gucci, you know. That's
my
dog.
Shout out to Gucci and Rocky. Son.
Yeah, Pops, love you, dog.
We are scooting and booting along in the episode. More good vibes in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Brother Pip, you love to see it?
Already? Already? Yeah. We seeing it all and we loving it when we see it. Because we love to see it.
Wow. That was beautifully said, brother. Kind folks out there. Where can they find you out, brother?
Pippi Long Sock.
Yup.
That's where you can find me. PIPPYLONGSOQ. Pippi Long Sock.
Yes, sir. Love to be able to do this again, Broski. Cause
I had a great time, my guy. Love everything you got going. Appreciate the invite again. Love the setup. It was dope, man. Glad we was able to get back together and you know what I'm saying? Link that camp for this time, man. Good fellowship, brotherhood, you know, this is for the culture, you know, this is good for Mansfield, Arlington.
Shout out Mansfield, you know, shout out Arlington.
You know, everybody got good stuff going on, you know, we just gotta keep going up, you know. Out of each and every one of us, you know, we still doing it. Shout out to my guy Shane too, just on here early. With the high school group with a guy. Yeah, he a real one, yeah.
Shane's and a good man.
I don't talk to too many people, But Shane, he's a good dude.
Quality brother. If you got someone who's quality in your life, ladies and gents, let them know. And if you're not letting them know, what the hell are you doing?
Great job. I appreciate you.
We appreciate you, ladies and gents. And if you enjoyed tonight's show, make sure to share it with your mom, dad, brother, sister, cousin, uncle, best friend, Phil down the street. Share it with anyone who needs some good vibes or good stories. Times in their life, because as we always say, ladies and gents, no one can overdose.
Good vibes, great people, glorious stories.
We'll see your beautiful faces soon.